Hello everyone, this is Vishwanath Chavan, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Now I am here to explain 8087 Numeric Data Processor. At the end of this session, students will be able to describe the block diagram of 8087 architecture and they will be able to explain the pin diagram of 8087. 8087 numeric data processor is having some other names like math coprocessor, or it can be called as numeric processor extension, or it may be called as floating point unit. It was the first coprocessor which is designed by Intel. These are paired with 8087, resulting in easier and faster calculation. Once the instructions are identified by 8086 processor, then it allocated to 8087 coprocessor for further execution. So it has different data types. We'll see what are those. It supports for binary integers, packed decimal numbers, real numbers, and temporary real format. Let us see the different features of 8087. It supports for different data types like integer, floating, and real types, and which are ranging from 2 to 10 bytes. The processing speed is so high that it can calculate multiplication of two different sizes like 64 bit width real numbers in 27 microseconds, and can also calculate square root in 35 microsecond. It follows IEEE floating point standard. Let us see the architecture of 8087. So mainly it has two parts. One is control unit and another is numeric extension unit. Let's see the different function unit of respective. So control unit is having data buffer, control word, status addressing and bus tracking, exception pointers, and these are the connections which is connected to external word and to numeric extension unit. So this unit has different function units like component module, microcode control unit, operand queue, tag word. So there is a register stack which is 8-bit, programmable shifter, arithmetic module, temporary register, and this is how connected to all these components. Now we'll see more detail about these two units, how it works. So 8087 architecture is divided into two groups. One is control unit, another is numeric extension unit. The control unit handles all the communication between processor and memory, such as it receives and codes, decodes instructions, reads, writes memory operand, and maintains parallel queue, etc. So all the coprocessor instructions are ESC instructions because it is identified that it is concerned with 8087. So that is, they start with F. The coprocessor only executes the ESC instructions while other instructions are executed by the microprocessor. The numeric extension unit handles all the numeric processor instructions like arithmetic, logical, data transfer instructions, etc. It has 8 registers type, which holds the operands or instructions and their results. So think about this question and try to answer. The question is, 8087 architecture is divided into how many parts and what are those? Pause this video and write the answer. I hope you answered. Let us see answer for this. The answer is 8087 architecture is divided into two groups. One is control group and another is numeric extension unit. Let us see the pin diagram of 8087. So total it has 40 pins. Pin number 1 ground, pin number 40 VCC, and address and data lines AD0 to up to AD19, and no connections, clock, ground, reset, ready, busy, QS1, QS0, S0, bar, S1 bar, S2 bar, no connection, RQ bar slash GT0, INT, RQ bar slash GT1 bar, BHE bar, S7, then S6, S5, S4, S3, like this. So we'll see more detail about all these pins. The following list provides the description of respective pins. AD0 to AD15. These are time multiplexed address and data lines. A stands address, D stands data. So which carry addresses during the first clock cycle and data from the second clock cycle onwards. Next, A16 to A19. Meanwhile, S3 to S6. So these lines are time multiplexed address slash status lines. It functions in a similar way to the corresponding pins of 8086. The S6, S4 and S3 are permanently high, while the S5 is permanently low. It has BHE, bus high enable, slash S7. During the first clock cycle, the BHE slash S7 is used to enable the data on the higher byte of the 8086 database, and after that it works as status line S7. QS0 and QS1. These are the queue status input signals, which provides the status of instruction queue, their conditions as shown in the following table. So QS0 and QS1. If both bits are 00, then the status is no operation. If it is 01, then first byte of opcode from the queue. If it is 10, then it is empty queue. If it is 11, and subsequently byte from queue is identified. So there is a INT pin, which is interrupt. It is an interrupt signal which changes to high when unmasked exceptions have been received during execution. Busy, it is an output signal. When it is high, it indicates a busy state to the CPU. Next one, ready, it is an input signal used to inform the coprocessor whether the bus is ready to receive the data or not. Next, reset. It is an input signal used to reset the internal activities of the coprocessor and prepare it for further execution whenever required by the CPU. Clock. The clock input provides the basic timings for the processor operation. Next, VCC. It is a power supply signal which requires plus 5 volt power supply for the operation of the circuit. Next, S0, S1, S2. These are the status signals that provide the status of the operation, which is used by the bus controller 8087 to generate memory and I/O control signals. These signals are active during the fourth clock cycle. Let us see the table which talks about status input signal S0, S1, S2. So the first two are unused. Next, 101, which indicates memory read. 110, which indicates memory write. 111, which indicates it's a passive. RQ/GT1 and RQ/GT0. These are the request and grant signals used by the 8087 processor to gain control of the bus from the host processor. 8086 for operand transfer. These are the references. Thank you.